every so often you have crazed Khawarij groups that carry black banners, and they will stand in London with the black banners and say, we are those black banners. Likewise, recently we had the Khawarij group ISIS, so-called Islamic State, and they had black banners. Some young people, they watch these YouTube videos of conspiracy theories and do not understand the hadith correctly. So when they see these groups carrying the black banners, they think these are the actual, this is the actual group of Al-Imam Mahdi radiallahu anhu. Because Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, who surprisingly again is not accounted for, they say they finished ISIS off. Where is the accountability of Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi? Where is he? Where is his body? Where is his, has he been arrested? Has anyone been taken to account and taken to trial for the crimes against humanity? Remember one thing with these groups, they mainly kill Muslims. So in Iraq, they cause sectarian division between the Shia and the Sunnis, causing them to kill one another in certain extreme fringe groups. And in Syria, doing the same, meaning division within a political division and causing people to kill one another. And yet no one is taken to account for these groups, that they are, where is Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi? So when people saw the black banners, they think these black banners are in reference to the army of Al-Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu. But the reality is that the army of Al-Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu that shall appear in Khurasan, they have one very significant sign. Firstly, before going on to that sign, one hadith states regarding Al-Imam al-Mahdi, when the oath of allegiance shall be given to him, لَا يُوقِظُ النَّائِمُ وَلَا يُهْرِيقُ الدَّمُ. Al-Imam al-Mahdi will be such a peaceful person that he shall not wake up the one sleeping, and he will not shed blood. At the time of the oath of allegiance, the power and authority that he shall ascend to will not be with the shedding of blood. This is something overlooked by people today. When Al-Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu shall be in Al-Masjid al-Haram, he shall not wake up anyone who is sleeping, and he shall not shed the blood of any Muslim or anyone else. And he shall get to he shall ascend to power. So he shall become the leader of that region without shedding blood. This is something very significant. So the group that shall support Al-Imam al-Mahdi shall be a group then that shall appear from Khurasan with black banners. They will place the black banners in Al-Quds al-Sharif in Jerusalem. This is the sign. Meaning any group that claims they are the carriers of the black banners and they carry black banners and they say in the early 2000s and the late 90s you had Al-Qaeda, the Al-Qaeda network made by CIA. So the CIA made a group of people known as Al-Qaeda, and then Al-Qaeda is carrying the black banners. And then in 1979 to 1989, they created Al-Qaeda, meaning they had the support of the government of General Zia and the support of the Saudi regime, and they imported in Wahhabi youth from the Najd region into Pakistan, North Pakistan, and then sent them into Afghanistan, and then they formed Al-Qaeda network. Then after 9/11, when 9/11 occurred, some people spread false information that Osama bin Laden is from the Ahlul Bayt, from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he is not. He's a Yemeni descent. He's not from the Sadat, from the Ashraf, in order to convince young people to be recruited into Al-Qaeda. When that finished, now you have Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. They claim he is from the Ashraf, from the Ahlul Bayt, in order to convince people that he is a Mahdi-like figure, or someone who will pave the way for Al-Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu. But all these are false flags. The real Al-Imam al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu firstly shall rise to ascendancy and power in Makkah al-Mukarramah without shedding blood. This is one of his main signs. Additional to that, the Muslims shall love him and give him the oath of allegiance. Meaning, irrelevant to what sect people belong to, majority of the Muslims will give the oath of allegiance to him. Then, a group of people from Khurasan shall rise, they shall have arms. They shall have arms, the people who rise in Khurasan. But they shall place the black banners in Al-Quds Sharif. Why is this significant? Because currently we have a Zionist occupation of Al-Quds Sharif. They shall finish the Zionist occupation of Jerusalem, Al-Quds Sharif.